facing tropical temperate cyclones extends up to Russia and India in winter. In India, it is called western disturbances. Extratropical cyclones are also called as mid-latitude cyclones. Extratropical cyclones produce mild showers to heavy gales, thunderstorms, blizzards, and tornadoes. Risk reduction measures before cyclone. Ignore rumors, stay calm, don't be panic. Keep your mobile phones charged to ensure connectivity. Use SIMs, listen to radio, watch TV, read newspapers for weather updates. After cyclone, take care of the old and young. Keep all family members inside the house. Switch off all electrical appliances. Stay in an empty room. After cyclone, those who shifted to cyclone centers must remain there till inspection are received. Strictly avoid loose electrical wires after the cyclone. Beware of snakes and other animals immediately after the cyclone. Thank you.
Yeah, Varsha, it's very nice. Content wise is very good. Maybe you could have paragraphed the whole subject in a better manner. I'll tell you what I mean by paragraph. Before that, there was some issue of audio problem in the beginning, but that was taken care of in the afterwards there was no problem. First of all, the paragraph means, all of you, I mean, this is for everybody, including me, to learn this. First of all, today we will look at cyclone, she said, very good. First we will look at the origin of this word cyclone. You could have said like that, origin of the word cyclone, and then you could have said it's a Greek word or whatever. That content you could have said. And there are three types of cyclone. One is called tropical cyclone and that, whatever, three or four types. Then you could have explained. And then what are the things we should do before the cyclone, during the cyclone and after the cyclone. Likewise, you could have given that heading and then you could have gone to the actual content. So now once you give that and you say, okay, let us look at what we should do before the cyclone. And you say what all you have said. What we should do during the cyclone, again you say what all you have said, again you say what we should do after the cyclone, etc., etc. So like that you can finish off. So you can paragraph your speech and then give a small heading like the way we write the essay, and then while talking you can mention those topics. You need not say topic word, but then you can mention the topic, and then sometimes you can mention the topic twice. Sometimes you can mention the topic twice so that people will understand that is a topic and then you are going to talk about it. Is it, Varsha, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is how you should paragraph your speech. Now, we will learn one by one. It's nice, content-wise very good, everything was very good. Maybe you could have gone little slower in terms of speech. Right now, you are going at, let's say, 60 km per hour. Maybe you could have gone by 45 km or 50 km per hour kind of thing. Slightly reduce your speed, then it will become very nice. Little bit of modulation also would have helped. Modulation means, for example, you said three types of cyclone, and tropical cyclone, that is a cyclone which we see in India. There you could have raised a voice. The cyclones which we see in our India is called tropical cyclone. You could have raised the voice little bit. So wherever you wanted to stress upon a particular point, raise your voice. And then lastly, you said after the cyclone, you have to be beware of snakes. So that you could have raised, little drama you could have made in your voice itself. You can make drama in your voice. So like that you can try, this and all you can do, and so that the speech will become more more sweet and people would love to listen to your speech, okay? But otherwise it's a great effort. Varsha, can you give me a small introduction about you to all our members?
Yes, sir. My name is Varsha and I am from Kanyakumari. I am studying in St. Joseph Convent. I am studying 10th standard.
Okay, very good. So, I think it's very interesting to listen to Varsha, that too about cyclone. Very good. Okay, I think your area is prone for cyclone, Kanyakumari. You get cyclone very frequently?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Kanyakumari is famous for what? Kanyakumari is famous for what, I said. I asked.
Special seas used to merge at a place, sir.
But one Tiruvalluvar statue is there, no, in Kanyakumari.
Yes, sir.
That is called what? Vivekananda Rock. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Good, good, good. Very good. I love that place. I had gone a couple of times. Maybe I would love to visit the place once again. It's a very beautiful place. One of the places, I mean, if all our other members have not seen, tell your parents when after the pandemic, when time permits, you visit once to Kanyakumari, primarily to this Tiruvalluvar statue. I think people who love Tamil, I think they should go there. It's a very big statue. That place is called, I think Vivekananda Rock or something. And in the evening, what is special about Kanyakumari in the evening?
Sunset.
Yeah, sunset, you can see the sunset very nicely in Kanyakumari, that's say. But I have never, I had been in the evening, but then I did not remember those things. But otherwise, it's a very, fine. Kanyakumari is comes under Nagarkoil district?
Yes, sir.
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good. Okay. Thanks, Varsha. Can we go to the next person?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, no, I would like sir. To...
Yeah. See, whenever I make a comment, it is comment for everybody, including me. I also have a long way to go in terms of improving my language. So, it is not only for Varsha, it's not only for Bhumika, like that. You have to take lessons from all the, others' experience also. Yeah, we will go to Mughil Shri.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, one and all present here. Today, the topic which I am going to talk is about music. Do you love hearing music? Yes, I like hearing music. Music is a very good opinion for everyone to be happy and busy in life. Music plays a great role in making us happy in a difficult time and gives lot of relief to our mind. There are many different types of music which we can enjoy according to our choice. Some people like listening music while studying. Music produces a kind of pleasure which human nature cannot do without, said by Confucius. In my own opinion, music is really a big kind of stress buster. I would like to end up my speech by asking you all a question. What is your favorite song? Mine is Yaar Alaipadhu from which is a song from Mara movie. Give your opinion.
Yeah, carry on.
That's it, sir. Thank you, everyone.
Oh, Mara movie. Mara movie I have not seen, but I have listened to this song, I think. This particular song. Okay, yes, you sir. Like that movie. But I know why Mughil Shri likes music. I know. Because it helps her to reduce her stress. The stress is given by her sister Kirti Sri. That too also I know.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, see, so definitely Mughil Sri needs a stress buster because Kirti Sri's disturbance, screaming, shouting, yelling, everything will disturb her. Is it true, Kirti?
Sir, no, sir.
No.
Sir, yes, sir.
Okay, so one yes and one no. That is the good spirit of sisters. Okay, thank you. So, very nice talk, Mughil Shri. Everything is fine. I would have loved you talking a little bit more about music, not the usefulness of the music. You said some different types of music. Maybe you could have gone a little bit. I was expecting, because many of us, I don't know about youngsters like you, many persons like me, we know music, but we don't know, and we know only Carnatic music, this and that. But we don't know exactly what is the difference, what is etc. We don't know. Maybe had you gone into that, I would have gained some knowledge. No problem. I think it's high time. It's high time we request Mughil Shri to sing a song.
Sir, I don't. You can't. You will go out of the class if I sing, sir.
No. We will not go out of the class. Who is a good singer in our class now? Who can sing very nicely? Any one of you? Anybody who would love to sing for a minute or two? Okay, no problem. This is planned
yes,
for.
Sir, you itself, sir. You itself.
Oh my God, my voice will be very, what to say. Again, I know a lot of songs, but then it may not be nice at this juncture. Okay, we will sing, we will have some other Google Meet only for singing. Okay, Kirti?
Okay, sir.
Okay, thumbs
sir,
up.
Which is your favorite music, sir?
No, I don't know. I mean, that is cinema songs only, actually. But earlier, I used to have a lot of devotional songs. I used to know. Katpagavallinin potpadangal piditen natkadi arulvayamma Devi katpagavallinin potpadangal piditen natkadi arulvayamma பட்பலரும் போற்றும் பதுமயிலாபுரியில் பட்பலரும் போற்றும் பதுமயிலாபுரியில் சிற்பம் நிறைந்த உயர் சிங்கார கோயில் கொண்ட கற்பகவல்லினின் பொற்பதங்கள் பிடித்தேன் நட்கதி அருள்வாயம்மா. ஓகே, மேபி திஸ் சாங் maybe my
super
favorite
super super song sir.
I know at least 100 songs by in my memory has got more than 100 songs because I learned at the age of Bhumika or Kirti Sri, kind of, you know, at that age, so it never forgets. So anytime, yes, if I wanted to sing, I have at least 100 songs, at least 3-4 lines I know. Okay, now I request who else? Premi, you would like to add,
sir,
your minute member?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Premi, here to talk about lasers. So, what is laser? We all know something about it. Light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. It is its full form. So, lasers are of three types: solid lasers, liquid lasers, and gas lasers. So, an example for solid laser is ruby laser. For gaseous laser is argon, that type of laser. Its use is, lasers are used in cardiac operations. If there is any block, it is used to remove that block. In sequencing instruments for DNA, semiconductors, this we'll study later. And it's used to drill some tiny holes in hard metals. It is used in soldering, drilling, welding, heart treatment, both in metals as well as in non-metals. It is used in some special glasses. So its use is very great in mankind. Thank you, one and all.
Yeah, thank you, Premi. Yes, Kamalika, we'll come back to you. No problem. Premi, it was a nice topic, laser, a technical topic. You really touched upon one of the very famous thing is, you know, there is a surgery called laser surgery for eyes. Have you heard of this? Kannuku, for eyes.
Yes, sir.
We have laser surgery.
Yes, sir.
Many of you would have known. So probably, you know, that is one thing which is very common to public people. Laser means, okay, it is used for surgery for eyes. That is one. And once upon a time, when I was like you, when kid, there was one English movie had come. And that laser was used by the villain to kill the hero, and laser was used like that, and that is the first time I had seen the laser. I heard of that word called laser. I think the movie name is The Spy Who Loved Me. I think so. I don't remember. It's an English movie. Okay, that's something. So it's nice that you have touched upon many things about laser. Maybe I would again love Premi, like Mughal Sri, you could have talked a little bit more about these novel topics, because many of us may not know about these things. We may be good listeners to music, but we may not know about music. They say ragam, talam, palavi and all. I don't know what all those things means. So similarly, we may know laser, but we may not know in detail about laser. Maybe we'll keep it on some other time. I think otherwise, I think Premi, you have to reduce your speed a little bit. Little bit modulation is required.
Okay, sir.
Speed like the way Mughal Sri spoke, no, that speed is enough. You know, you need not be very fast. Little bit modulation is required. And when you are explaining the application, you are speeding up. In the end, I do not know. Maybe, you know, that also you could consciously you work on this. You know, you tell yourself, okay, I should reduce speed, etc. Then automatically you will reduce the speed. Your speech will become more sweet. Okay, right. Okay, next,
okay,
who is coming? I think, Samita.
Sir,
Samita.
Shall I, sir?
No, we will give the chance to Samita because
yes,
Samita was waiting. Yeah.
Good afternoon to one and all present here. Today I am speak about our state animal. Do you know which is the state animal of ours?
Varayadu.
Varayadu.
In English?
I don't know. Varayadu only they say. Okay.
It is Nilagiritar.
Okay.
Nilagiritar. It is listed as endangered on International Union for Conservation of Nature's Red List. Nilgiri tar is also known as Nilgiri ibex or just ibex. It is known as Varayadu in Tamil. They are mostly found in two kinds of groups, mixed groups comprising 150 in number and an all male group which has about 20 members. Nilgiri tar is closely related to the Himalayan tar found in the south of the Himalayas and the Arabian tar found in Oman. They feed on grass, shrubs, lichen, and fresh shoots of bamboo. The Nilgiri tar weighs 80 to 100 kgs and has a height of around 100 cm. The male's horn grows up to 40 cm. The predators of Nilgiri tar include tigers, leopards, jackals, and wild dogs. Tar are the most active during evening. Thank you.
Yeah, very nice, Samita. I think you have improved a lot from the day I have listened to you some 2-3 weeks back. Primarily, your clarity of words are there. Pronunciation is good. You have reduced, I think the speed also is okay. It's very good. Whenever you talk any new word, say for example, Oman. Oman is a country, but then you have to spell it. You need not spell it, but you have to pronounce it properly. Otherwise, no, I just listened Oman. That's all. That N is missing. So maybe, you know, whenever you talk about noun, whenever you speak about a noun, a name or a place or something, you have to spell out very clearly. If this mistake I do very often in my speech, you would have seen in my video also. Whenever I talk about the noun, my sound comes down. I do not know. I have not able to, you know, practice that. But I love you people practice and correct those things. No, it will be beneficial to you in the future years to come. So, Samita, you made a very nice speech. Can we go to Bhumika? Are you there?
So, can I?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. We will go to Arshidal next. First, we will go to Bhumika. Yeah, Bhumika.
Hi, everyone. I am Kamalika. Today, I talk about how to improve our English vocabulary knowledge. First, how was improving vocabulary accomplished? According to Oxford University Press, students need to be able to do so much more than read off lists of vocabulary. They need to be able to manipulate the language so that it can support their communicative needs. Students must use a new word 10 to 16 times before it sinks in. Teaching vocabulary goes beyond memorizing words with a flashcard. It is process that begins with the encountering a word and hence when a student can produce the word. Okay, here I talk with the 5 tricks and the tips help our to increase their vocabulary. First one, take a systematic approach to vocabulary practice. Students should be encouraged to learn new vocabulary daily, but in short spurts. This is the best way to make it stick. The expert says, half a day, too much at one time, means most of it will be lost in things in the long term. Instead, if students commit in to just 15 minutes of a day of focused practice, they will soon have a solid linguistic base of new words and a definition. Second thing, reading for meaning. Reading for meaning is a research-based strategy that helps all readers make a sense of challenging texts. Reading is one of the most effective ways to teach the vocabulary, and regular reading is the strategy that gives students the opportunity to practice and master the phases of critical reading that leads to reading success and improved word usage. Third thing, teach a vocabulary in context. Going through a list of words that are not connected to a subject or story or each other is the wrong approach. Instead, use a subject like a car to build use adjectives, fast, big, compact, fuel, electric, automatic, manual, etc.
Teachers can then ask students to answer questions based on descriptions or create their own fill-in-the-blanks assignments. Fourth thing, teach vocabulary specific to the content. Content-specific refers to terms, concepts, or vocabulary having specific meaning, critical, or understanding particular content. A student's maximum level of reading comprehension is determined by his or her knowledge of books. Teacher's keyword that the children will need to comprehend the text and learn the content in those texts. Word assisting word association. Word association is an activity that can be used with large classes and limited resources. How it works, write a word on the board and then get your students to say the first word that pops up in their head which has the relation to the word on the board. It is a good idea to go around the class getting each student to give a word. If a student cannot come up with a word, this is perfect opportunity to go over the meaning. Finally, teaching vocabulary within the common core stage standards is an essential component to standard based circumalignment. Making the critical word second nature to our students will enhance achievement on assessment and will be useful in college and career according to author Marley Spen. Thank you to
Yes, Kamalika. Yeah, you made a very good, you touched upon a very important topic. Maybe we will have one class for this purpose. It's very useful to everybody. Because by the time you complete 10th standard in matriculation, you should have known 1,200 words. That is what the government says. 1,200 English words. Let me tell you, by the time you complete, now if you recall those words, I think you may not be able to recall more than 200 words. So this is the status of many students, including me, I am saying. All of us. So we would have heard of 1,200 words, but then we may not be able to recall it. So how do we improve vocabulary? This is a very important thing. Whoever wants to write many of these exams, like GRE, TOEFL, and then SAT, and many competitive exams, this particular improving your vocabulary is very useful. We will spend some time in our class itself. Of course, as Kamalika is rightly put it, probably, we have many techniques to improve our vocabulary. We will do a special class on that. Kamalika, you could have gone little slow, particularly in the beginning. Little slow in the particular beginning. This is my comment. We will go, because since paucity of time, we'll go to the next person, Arshida.
Yes, sir. Hello, good afternoon, everybody. Today, I'm going to speak about the importance of time in human life. Time is the continuous sequence of events that take place in an apparently irreversible succession from the past through the present to the future. A person lives in this world within a time that is expressed in the same matter. For 10 years ago, you were not the same as you are today. Neither in your appearance, nor in your knowledge, nor in your experiences, everything around changes with the passage of time. In this article, we will talk about the importance of this time in human life. The importance of time in our life. Time has great importance in human life, including time is related to all that is going on around us. So we often hear about the time dimension because time is an essential element of life. Time represents special milestones, including birthdays, anniversaries, and the birth of babies, and helps us recognize, organize our daily lives and activities so we can live a more organized and productive life. From sunset till night, high tide and low tide due to the moon. The four seasons, everything is completely time dependent. Human life is measured by time. And the cycle of the sun, moon, and earth is known as time. And through the time, we know the year, month, week, day, hour, minute, second, and parts thereof. And each time helps us to calculate the speeds of objects and the like. At the time, we know the acts of worship, especially the prayer, which God made upon the believers, a time book, meaning that it is performed at the appointed time without delay. Likewise, we find that all worship has a close relationship with time. If we want to know the importance of time, ask students about the importance of the time when they fail a test. Ask the mother about the importance of time when she is about to give birth. Ask the importance of time to somebody who is preparing to pass the biggest interview in their life. Ask the importance of time to an Olympic runner who prepares himself for the biggest competition of his life. Ask a patient about the importance of the time when he is told that he does not have much time to live. Why time is very important in our lives? Time is one of the most mysterious force in the universe. Time plays a significant role in our life. Time helps us make a good habit of structuring and organizing our daily activities. Why does time matter so much? So I'm going to convey you 10 reasons why time is so important. Time acts as both a teacher and a healer. Sometimes the only way to get a new, healthy outlook on a situation is to give it time. Time teaches us the value of life and makes you feel happy to be alive. A difficult or a painful situation will seem less bad as time passes. Time is the one thing that you can never get back. Once time has gone, it will never return. Third, nobody knows how much time they have. People can die at any age for any reason. Every single thing in the universe is bound to time. Gradually, all things start aging and eventually decay as time progresses. We are aware of three stages of time: the past, the present, and the future. But the only time we actually have is the present. Time affects happiness. A person's perspective of time has a big impact on their happiness and peace of mind. Mastering our available time is essential. Managing it poorly or well has a huge impact on life. Skills development takes time. Whether that skill is what you love or what you think is best for you. Future, it depends on how much time you invest. Relationships are made or broken to the moment amount of time you invest. The amount of time you invest is often the main difference between a deep relationship, loyalty, and one that's shallow. Then last but not least, everyone has the same 24 hours a day. So no one can complain about not having time for the things they want to do. So I am concluding my speech for now and hope you will all understand the importance of time. Thank you.
Oh, wow, Varshita, you have touched upon many dimensions of time. Such a content is so rich. Your talk also is very good. Okay, little bit of that audio problem was there. Small problem, not a big one. I think we would love to hear from you once again on the same topic, because you touched up on, it's almost for me like a listening to a spiritual guru, spiritual philosopher talking on time, isn't it? I think many of our friends will agree. Such a wonderful talk. I think, Arshita, can you give a small introduction about you to all our friends?
Yes, sir. My name is Arshita and I'm from Coimbatore. And I'm studying in Kendriya Vidyalaya, Sauribalayam. I'm a student of 9th.
Yeah, good. Good, Arshita, yeah, for your introduction. So anyway, it's nice. We need to learn a lot of things like this, but the content was very rich. Really, I think you prepared well, whatever it is, you know, maybe you have downloaded somewhere, but it's very good. Time is between your death and the birth and the death. Whatever happens, that is the time that you have. So by the time we started this class, now almost more than half an hour we have spent. So we are half an hour nearer to our graveyard, isn't it? So that is how we have to feel about the time, give importance to the time. By the time we complete this class, we will be 1 hour nearer to our graveyard. So time is such a precious thing. So we need to make use of it in a nice manner. So thank you, Archita, for your wonderful speech. Maybe, no, we have
welcome,
to take,
sir.
We have to take into different dimensions. For example, now we are talking, we are need to take Mughal Shri, Kirti Shri, everybody, all others to conversational level. And secondly, you know, it is some kind of you know, fighting each other, you know, argument between two people, or it could be a negotiation in a, with the supplier of some computer or something. So like that, we will take a different dimensions on communication one by one at in the later classes. Thank you. So Jayabharathi, can I request you to present? Jayabharathi, are you there?
Sir.
Kirti, I will come back to you. I mean, Jayabharathi, I think she raised her voice sometime back. Jayabharathi, are you there? Okay, we will go to Kirti Shri. Yes.
Hi everyone, the topic I'm going to speak on is left alone grandmother. A grandmother who's eagerly waiting to interact with her family who are busy in their modern world. But she was left alone unnoticing. She was worried about her family that they were always busy in using gadgets like cell phones, laptops, iPad, etc. Grandmother felt very ignored. She feels alone and left lonely. No one in the family feels bothered about her sad feelings. Thank you.
Oh, Kirti, short and sweet. As usual, Kirti will touch upon the real life episodes. I think she will become a good director of some drama or movie or something like that. I mean, the way she builds her speech every time. She always, you know, speaks something which is happening in our family on a daily basis. Or in somewhere it happens daily basis. So I think hats off to you, Kirti. And only one place I think there was slight grammar mistake. That is, she is left unnoticing. I think something like that you said. I think the right word is unnoticed. Okay. That is the thing. So maybe that's maybe whether I heard it properly, I do not know. But if I have heard it properly, then you correct it. That's the only thing which I wanted to convey. So, anybody else who would like to share? Who else is
sir,
there?
Sir, I would like.
Yeah, Varsha. Yes, Varsha.
Is my audible, sir?
What, madam?
Voice is audible or not?
Yeah, it's audible. It's audible. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. Now I am here to speak in the title of protein and I also explain the cause. Direct consequences of accidents and preventive measures for accidents.
Well,
road accidents are the leading cause.
Same thing you want
road
to talk about.
Sir?
You already spoke, no, Varsha?
What, sir?
Did you speak this topic already? You have spoken? No.
No, sir.
Okay, carry on.
Yes, sir. Road accidents are the leading cause of death by injury and the 10th leading cause of all deaths globally. An estimated 1.2 million people are killed in road crashes each year, and as many as 15 million people are injured. With over 130,000 deaths annually, India has the world's worst accident rate worldwide. Every 3 minutes, a child is killed in an accident in the world. The main causes of death of accident include drunk and drive 40%, speeding for 24%, kaboom in India 16%, inefficient law enforcement for 15%, and less use of helmets, seatbelts 5%. It also includes distraction of drivers, red jumping, overtaking in a wrong manner. Direct consequence of acts or fatality, injury, damage, property, preventive measures for accidents, education and awareness about road safety, strict enforcement of law, engineering, vehicle design, road infrastructure. An estimation in 2016, it's the top city by number of road accidents. So finally, what is my conclusion is, rush driving is thrilling, but it leads to killing. Thank you.
Oh, nice. That's a very important topic. Of course, some problem I think in audio is there, little problem, but I think it's no issue. you can improve upon. Your audio also you can improve, your speech also you can, but content wise is very good, very important thing, because we are losing 1.2 million people every year due to road accidents. It's very bad, no? So your ride may be thrilling, but it may be killing you in case you don't take care of the proper rules. So should I go to next person? Anybody would love to speak? I request all of you to use this platform to try out and enrich your experience and improve your communication skills. No, I mean, whoever has not spoken, no problem. Next time you can speak, but use this. I'll come. Use this platform. That is my request. Again and again, I reach to all the kids, not only in this class, in other class, because make use of this platform. You don't get, when you go to college or something, you know, you will get a lot of other platforms, but not the platform where you can improve your language command and things like that. Okay. Can we go to Malathi? Yes.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Malathi. I would like to say about V. Irayanbu. Irayanbu is an IAS officer, writer, educator, social activist, and motivational speaker. He is the current chief secretary of Tamil Nadu. Irayanbu born in Kattur village in Salem district on 16 June 1963. Born in a middle class family, he wanted to live a well-intentioned life since his school days. His father's name is Venkatachalam and mother's name is Saroja. He has a brother named Thirupugal, who is also an IAS officer. Irayanbu has a motivational speaker and hosted a show named Kaluri Kalangal, in which he shared his experience about his college life. He has written more than 150 books. And a good, great IAS officer in India. Thank you.
Thank you, Malathi. Can you introduce yourself to everybody?
Yes, sir. I am Malathi. I am studying 11th standard in Seva Sangam Girls Higher Secondary School. And my mother name is Selva Kumari. My father name is Ramasamy. I have one sibling, Sudhakar. He is a younger brother studying 8th standard. My hobbies is reading books.
And, yeah, thank you. Thank you, Malathi, for giving an introduction. No, see, Malathi is a great speaker, great Tamil speaker. But I would love all the Tamil speakers to come and practice English speaking also in this class. Similarly, the English speaking people also can try out the speaking in Tamil. Both the ways, you should be very good in both the languages. I extend my request to all the Tamil loving people. Malathi can express to others, because he is in touch with many of them. Because this is one platform, because many of the people have said that this is a platform where students can make mistake, no problem, they learn, and this is the place, and then hone their skills, and then they can develop it, and when they go out of the college or school, they will come up with flying colors in their career. So that was the whole idea. So you make use of this opportunity. Right. Can we go to the class a little bit? No, class, I have one minute. We need to, this thing, no? We need, I will share a screen. Okay. So in this slide, I don't know when I made this slide, how to tell your boss no without saying no. Maybe in your case, how to tell your teacher no without saying no. Let us see what are the techniques they have in place. Situation. Situation is you truly don't have the time. Instead of, there is no way I have time for that. Instead of saying, there is no way I have time for that, you should say, could you help me prioritize my project list? See, suppose your teacher is giving some assignment or some work and you really don't have the time. How will you reply to your teacher? So normally we say, there is no way I have time for that. We will say like that, or to your friend or a senior friend. But instead of saying that, you can try like this. Could you help me prioritize my project list? You can put the ball in their court. You can put your various projects or the work you have. and ask them to prioritize your work. By doing that, they will appreciate that you have many other works which is more important than this particular work, and then they will spare you from doing this particular work. Am I conveying this to you? Hello, am I conveying this to you properly?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to understand? See, this is a situation in a company, the boss will give lot of work for a person who is doing very well. Let's say one executive is doing extremely well, but the boss will give more work to him. So, and this person normally would not say no, but there is a limit for everything, no? And one time he has to say no. So, instead of saying no, they say, could you help me prioritize my project list? You throw upon what all the works you have with the boss, and let the boss will help you to prioritize. By saying that, it's not that he's going to do the job for you, but he will spare you from that particular job, for that particular work. So that is one thing we can try. So should we try in our life this thing? Kirti? Now you can try such things and escape some work from your mother. Kirti Sri is there?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Now you, instead of saying no, I will not do that work. No way, I don't have time. Instead of saying that, you say, could you help me prioritize my various homework that is given from the school? Like that, if you tell your mother, she will think that you really have lots of homework, and then she will not give that particular work to you, whatever work she had in mind. Am I helping you in some way or other? Hello, Kirti. Okay, no problem. Right, next. Situation, you disagree with the strategy at hand. You disagree with the point or with the idea at hand. Instead of saying that, I don't think that will work. Normally, somebody asks, we will do a particular thing. No, we will do a jogging for some 10 kilometers. But then you know very well it may not work for you, or may not work for both of you. So instead of saying, I don't think that will work, then you can say, can I throw out another idea? You can say that. Can I throw some other an alternative for that? Right? So something like that you can say, so that the other man will not get hurt. No, instead of saying no, hurt somebody. When you say a word no, it normally hurts somebody. How do we say no without saying no? So you can say, can I throw out another idea? Like this, you can tell your boss or your friend or teacher or your friend, then they will understand, or they will know that you are not agreeing with that particular strategy. Okay, let's go to the next situation. You just don't want to. You just don't want to do something. Just don't want to join them. You just don't want to cooperate with them. Instead of whenever they say something, you will no, we say immediately. Then you say sure. Sure, usually. What do you mean by that? Yes, I will join you sure, usually, but this time I cannot. That is the meaning of it. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So, sure, usually means, sure, I will usually join for such meetings. Suppose everybody is asking Kirti Sri's friends, hey Kirti, come on, we will go for the matinee movie. A new movie has come. Let's go. And Kirti does not want to go with that girl, let us say. Instead of saying, no, he said, sure, usually means, usually I would have come with you, but today you please excuse me. Something like that. Looks useful, Kirti?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so you can make, this is a very polished, I would, somebody asked me one thing about current children, etc., current generation. I said I would have loved to live in this generation along with you, because so much opportunities, so much interactions, so much openness from the parents, so much to learn, so many gadgets. I would have loved to come to this world after 60 years or maybe after 50 years and come along with all of you like kid, like you and then start learning many things. So that is the kind of opportunity is there in the world as of now. Okay, let's go to one more. I think already 3:39. One more thing. Let's see. I don't know what I have. Okay, communicative PPT 11. Predicting. Suppose you have to predict something. Who's done? So how do you frame your sentences? No, whenever you wanted to predict a sentence, which will give the meaning, which will do predicting. So how do you frame a sentence? Do you think he is going to get selected? So you are asking such a question. It's almost, it has got a prediction there. The sentence has got a prediction. Do you think he is going to get selected? What is the prediction is hidden in there in that sentence?
He won't get
selected. Yeah, he won't get selected. That's the thing. Who stands a chance of winning the election? No, here, who stands a chance of winning the election? It is a question. It's a question mark. What do you think is going to happen? So these are some ways you can ask about the future. I don't think he's going to get the bail. No, whenever somebody is getting they get arrested, they will ask for bail. No, somebody may get a bail, somebody may not get a bail. So he says, I don't think he's going to get a bail. These are the ways how we frame a sentence to talk about the future, which is, in other words, it's a predicting. It's a prediction. So let's go to the next one. Making requests indirectly and politely. I think this we have seen, no? I don't know. I was just wondering if you could lend me the CD. I was just wondering if you could lend me the book. I was just wondering if I could use your phone. I was just wondering if you could attend it today. Instead of saying, give me your phone, give me your book, give me your CD. You could have say, you can start the sentence with, I was just wondering if you could lend me the book. That is a very nice way of putting across a request to your friend so that she cannot say no to you. When somebody listens to you like this, a sentence like this, it's very difficult for them to say no to you. So you can frame this sentence and then make use of it in your daily conversations. Okay, go to next. What is this? Making inquiries indirectly and politely. I was just wondering if I could meet Dr. Mohan now. I was just wondering if you want to change the car. I was just wondering if you could conduct special classes. I was just wondering if special classes could be arranged. So all these sentences start with I was just wondering, or I wonder, like this. Use these words, keep this in mind consciously, use these phrases accordingly, and make your speech very, very sweet. What is this? Making informal suggestions and giving advice. What if we went by car? See, what if we went by car? It is a past tense, but it is referring to past tense to refer the present. You are using the past tense, but you are referring the present. What about going for the movie today? So what about going for the movie today? We are using ing form to refer to the present or future. How about placing it in the hall? No, you are yet to place it in the hall, but you are asking whether I can place it in the hall. So instead of using saying that kind of sentence, you can use how about placing it in the hall. There is a meeting on Monday. How about attending it? What about attending it? What if we attended it? All three are correct. How about attending it? What about attending it? What if we attended it? All three are correct. Even though the meeting is Monday, that is future, in one place you are using present continuous, in another place you are using past tense. You can use past tense to refer the present or the future. So this is the way you can frame a sentence. It's all grammatically also is correct. Okay. So these are some of the things which I wanted to share as far as the class is concerned. So now we will close at this. I will send you these PPTs. Make use of your conversation using these tips on your how to frame a sentence. I think Kirti, you will do it. I think
yes,
she will do it. She will do it. Okay, good. So any questions from anybody? Any questions from anybody? I will be pleased to answer your questions. Otherwise, we will meet next Sunday. And today evening at 5:30, we have an English debate. and at least 25 to 30 people from outside are expected to come, because I've invited a lot of people. Many people have showed interest. Let us see how it goes. And this meeting is moderated by our Ilakya, one of our old speaker, but other four people are new speakers. Okay, thank you so much.